I think we met in Philly at a special place called Dowlin's Palace.
Oh. Back to Dowlin's Palace. That's a reoccurring theme on this show. Okay. At Just Works.
Which venue?
Broad and Thompson, actually. Which
the original recipe.
I was late to that party. Mm-hmm. When I started going to Dowlin's Palace, I was still in high school.
Wait, yeah. What was this?
You was young.
I was young. I was probably like 11th grade, probably 2009.
Because the reason why I say, because the way that I remember meeting you, me watching you there, I'm like, wait a minute, this dude, okay, I see what he's doing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, because it's like there's different kind of wordsmiths, right? Then there's scientific wordsmiths. You know what I'm saying? Because I consider myself more on the intricate side of wordsmithery, if you will.
Yes.
And you, my friend, and again, as a very young man, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Like your level of emceeing, it wasn't common, mm-hmm. right? So let's start with you, man. Like where did this? How long you been rhyming? What different forms of rhyming were you into before you got into where you are now?
Okay, so when I was, I want to say 8 or 9 years old, I used to pick up magazines.
Okay.
And I might have been younger than that, actually, but I used to pick up magazines. I would go into the books and I would just write down words from the books.
Hmm.
Just paragraphs that I couldn't understand. Stanzas that didn't all the way make sense to me, and I would just write whatever I saw, copied and pasted, and then I would add different parts to create a story. Mm-hmm. Then I would go and present these stories of all of this literature to my brother and his girlfriend at the time, and they would just crack up because none of it made sense. So I think that was the first time I understood entertainment through something that I could create, and I think that's what gave me my first N.
Okay.
You know, my first interest. And from there, I got into listening to my brother listen to Nas.
You listen to your brother listening to Nas. Okay.
Yeah, because I wasn't necessarily listening to the music, but they would be reciting it all day throughout the house. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, I thought it was him. I thought this was his shit. Like, you know, baby being born, first time a man is murdered, the beginning and end, as far as rap go. I'm thinking that's my brother's shit.
This nigga nice.
Yeah. So.